All right, so I got Ori stepping in with me. We're going to have Kesa versus Amiibo King. Amiibo King matches are always...
They're always interesting, especially since the dude's real good at the Fox matchup.
Oh, yeah. Isn't he, like... Doesn't he have, like, a perfect record on Colony?
Yeah, I think it's, like, 2-0.
Yeah, I think it's 2-0. I don't want to say, like, maybe they played it, like, a weekly or something in Ohio. I don't want to say, like, perfect, but...
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure he's positive, at least, so...
He's 2-0 in at least tournament sets, and that's for sure. And you know Colony's probably going to try and get some revenge when he comes up on Saturday
Breakout.
All right, but Kesa dominating the early game with his tremendous neutral game like we always see from Kesa. Always mixing it up with the jabs and just knowing how to apply like safe pressure.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, that was a really solid jump read. Amiibo King probably reading the wrong recovery option.
Yeah.
Expecting him going high with the PK Thunder, because I believe PK Fire would have caught Illusion to the ledge. That would have set up an edgeguard situation.
Yep. And you'll see, like, this is something that's pretty fundamental about Amiibo King. Or not Amiibo King. Amiibo King. Amiibo King. He is a dash attack fiend.
Oh, yeah.
Dash attack, like PK Thunder, is one of its favorite moves to always press.
Uh-oh.
That's going to kill.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Ooh, the old grab plus back. The old Amiibo King special, as told by Beep McBoop.
You ran at me at the ledge, and you traded with my PK Fire. Goodbye.
Now, can you imagine if Amiibo King made this upset right now? I mean, sure, it's only game one, so we have, like, potentially two more games of adaptation.
Yeah.
But
speaking of adaptation.
Yeah, oh, my gosh. But who knows? Amiibo King shown that he can make comebacks after... pretty devastating early game. He definitely made that quick comeback with a PK Thunder to back throw. But you know, Kesa is going to start watching out for that more.
Oh, yeah. Amiibo King took a lot of damage there, too, from up tilts just because he was opting for an option every time. Like, he was either trying to, like, nair or...
You know, that was actually...
There were a lot of... Oh, my gosh!
Kesa, please. You know, I saw it coming, and I'm like, man, you know, Kesa is not wise for just standing there mid in the flame jabbing, because sure, he's trading damage, but he's trading damage on Amiibo King for, like, hitting him with PK Fire.
Yeah.
But you're also, like, damaging him, and all he needs is to, like, hit you with something like a bat or an up B2, and he gets him with the up B2.
Wait, why did Amiibo King switch?
Battlefield.
I don't understand. Oh, maybe stage. Yeah, maybe stage. I
think it's the battlefield choice. Mewtwo does. I mean, this is one of Mewtwo's best stages, if not his best, from what I've been told from multiple Mewtwo players, plus other top players. So maybe he just feels more comfortable doing this matchup here on battlefield. Oh my God, but Amiibo King.
I actually am a personal believer that Amiibo King. Oh my God!
Oh my God! Amiibo King's Mewtwo is actually like super legit.
No, I was about to say I'm actually a believer in Amiibo King's Mewtwo being better than his Ness.
It is. So. It is. It's just it looks
see,
like.
See that?
It just
see
looks
that?
Like his Ness is better.
Oh yeah, well he plays Ness more. That's the only thing. But like his Mewtwo is dope.
Yeah. Oh my God, we have a huge crowd coming around right now. Potentially watching the biggest. Oh my God! He should have been dead.
Yeah.
He should have been dead.
Sometimes characters have weird animations.
Up there, that's gonna kill. 69%. 69. Oh,
all right. You should have just taunted once, man. You made it cheesy by taunting.
Dude, he was also at the gold. He was actually at the golden percent. So that's honestly what helped kill him, despite Fox's lightweight.
Yeah. Fox and Mewtwo, both, like, insanely light characters. I think Fox is tied for, like 4 through 6 or something like that. And then Mewtwo, I think, is the third lightest? Or
yeah,
is he lighter than
is,
Game & Watch?
He's the third. He's heavier than Game & Watch after the recent weight
After
buffs.
The buff. Okay, because I know he was originally lighter.
Yeah, he was the second lightest before the weight nerf.
Okay.
Or weight buff, I guess. Also, well, I want to know what your opinion on this matchup. Do you think this is a winning or losing matchup for Fox? I think it's even or borderline or 55-45 for Mewtwo.
Yeah, no, I think Mewtwo wins, honestly. And I know Larry hates this matchup.
That's what I was going to bring up. We see Larry opt to go Donkey Kong whenever he fights Abadongo.
And
we saw it at CEO.
Abadongo, like, never loses to any Fox. Not just Larry. He never loses to, like, any Fox ever. Mm-hmm. So it may just be that, like, Mewtwo's ability to edge guard, combo, kill Fox early. You know, he's not really easy to landing trap.
Mm-hmm. I think it might also do with Mewtwo's general floatiness. It might disrupt a lot of the Fox bread and butters that we're so used to seeing.
Oh, yeah.
All right, what is he going to do? Oh, that's it.
That's it.
Amiibo King just 2-0'd K-Sev.
And he's going to move on to play Game Liking. This was seeded to be K-Sev Lurich, but now it's Amiibo King Game Liking.
So that means the winner...